Hello, my name is Dimos Gkitsakis. I'm with the University of Ioannina, and along with my co-authors Spyridon, Kaloudis, Eirini, Mouselli, Veronika, Peralta, Patrick, Marcel, and Panos Vassiliadis, we present methods in which we can assess the interestingness of cube queries. The problem that we discuss in this paper is that given a cube query and some prior knowledge expressed as already answered queries or simply user beliefs, how can we assess how interesting a cube query is based on interestingness dimensions? The context of the problem is that we have cube querying sessions over a multidimensional hierarchical database. The user has some prior knowledge about the cube, like query history or simply his beliefs, and the user devises queries in order to acquire new information. Each query is relevant or not with respect to the user's information goal, is different or similar to the queries of the history, contradicts or reinforces the user's beliefs, and provides new or already seen information. Each query is assessed with respect to the dimensions of relevance, peculiarity, surprise, and novelty. Now, the first question someone would have is, why bother? Why is this problem important? So for many fields, assessing how interesting a piece of information is important. For us, evaluating a priori and a posteriori query interestingness is very important. For the first one, selecting queries of high interest out of many candidates for further processing saves important time. And for the second one, analyzing the results of the most interesting queries that have been already executed also is a helping procedure. For example, in Delian cubes, which is the system in which we have implemented the algorithms that we are going to present, we also have a very first version of a describe operator, a simple operator that answers cube queries and provides information for the results that are not already known. For example, clusters of the result cells and top bottom k values. For such a system, being able to select the most interesting queries out of many candidates is very important for an a priori evaluation. And for an a posteriori evaluation of interestingness, having a big pool of already executed queries allows us to analyze the results of the most interesting queries of the pool. Now, as for related work, exploratory data analysis systems use interestingness dimensions as metrics in order to score the insights, highlights, or findings that they extract. Specifically, peculiarity is the dimension that attracts the most attention due to the simple fact that different data are more intriguing. Novelty is used in order to guarantee that data are new and move further the exploration. Relevance is used in order to characterize data based on how familiar is the user with them. And finally, surprise characterizes values that are not shown frequently or challenge user prior beliefs. Finally, self-interestingness is very important and well addressed, but we think that it's not enough. We need to assess cube query interestingness before the query execution too. Now, as for multidimensional data space, we focus on multidimensional hierarchical data organized in cubes. Due to the fact that cubes are relevant to the problem, simple and information rich. Cubes are formed in multidimensional spaces produced by combinations of dimensions and store measures in their cells. Dimensions provide context for measures and consist of levels organized in hierarchies of granularity. A cube query, which is a cube itself, is specified by a cube over which it is applied, a selection condition, which is a composition of atomic filters for the cube cells, the grouping levels, which determine the detail of the result, and an aggregation over the cube measures. Now, detailed area is the representation of the cells of a query result in the most detailed levels of the respective dimensions. A detailed area can be used as common ground for the comparison of cells of different queries that initially were in different levels of detail. For example, for the query queue, we see that at first the cells are represented in the space of the levels district and month, while their detailed area is a much larger multidimensional space with the levels account ID and SKD for the respective dimensions. Now, interestingness is a generic term indicating the extent to which a piece of information is interesting. We believe that we cannot express interestingness as a single entity or metric, but rather as a vector of scores along several dimensions. For example, the dimensions that we use is relevance, surprise, novelty, and peculiarity. Relevance is the extent to which a new piece of information, for us the results of the query, are related to the overall information goals of the user. Surprise, on the other hand, is the extent to which the result of a query contradicts, revises, or updates the user's prior beliefs. Novelty is the extent to which the information presented to the users is new and previously unseen to them. And finally, peculiarity is the extent to which the query is different and not in accordance with previous queries of a session or history. Now, some terminology. We have syntactic versus extensional assessment. The first is based only on query definition, and the second includes the cells of the result. We have same level versus detailed assessment. The first occurs when two assessed cubes are in the same level of aggregation, while the second uses their most detailed levels of aggregation as common ground in order to compare the cells. And finally, we have full versus partial assessment. The first means that the results of the assessment will include a true-false answer, while the second returns a real number in the scale of 0 to 1. Novelty assesses the amount of previously unknown information produced by a query, and is most related to the query history and register values for beliefs with confidence below a certain threshold. For example, let's assume we have a history queries over a multidimensional space, and in this figure we have the representation in this space. We can see that all use a same schema, which is the same levels for their respective dimensions as groupers, and the same measure. Each of the queries have different filters, giving them different space in the whole multidimensional space. Now the idea is that a new query queue is executed, and we want to assess how novel is this query with respect to query history. In order to do that, we have two ways. The first is detailed assessment of novelty, an algorithm that returns the fraction of the detailed cells of queue which are not covered by the detailed areas of history queries over the entire detailed area of queue. And we have also same level assessment of novelty, which basically is an algorithm that if a query with identical syntax with Q is found, returns 0, otherwise returns 1. Detailed extensional novelty of Q is 0.7, which means 70% of the detailed cells of Q are not previously seen, and the fully syntactic same level novelty is 1, which means no identical queries found in the query history. There is also the chance to evaluate novelty in the presence of user's belief, where is no explicit knowledge about the query history, and we simply have beliefs, which are estimation of probabilities about the distribution of values for some cells. For example, a user belief is that for the city Athens in the year 2020, the sales of a product were in between 80 and 1,000 with a probability of 70%. For these probabilities, we set a threshold, for example, 50%, and estimation of probabilities that exceed or are equal to P are named P known. Cells that are covered by a P known belief are considered known. And we have an algorithm partial detailed extensional belief that when a detailed cell of Q is also known, is considered not novel. And the algorithm returns the ratio of the detailed not covered and therefore novel cells of Q over the entire detailed area of Q. For this algorithm, the belief novelty of the previous example, the query Q, and some user beliefs is 0.97, which indicates high novelty based on the user beliefs. Now we have relevance, which is an interestingness dimension that pertains to retain focus towards a specific information goal or a set of them. And in the case that the goal is given by the user, relevance is calculated simply by comparing another question query and the user-specified goal. In the case where the goal is not given and is a frequent one, the goal has to be inferred from collateral profile information. And specifically, we use the query history because it provides a space of data that has been already seen from the user in the current session and therefore can be considered relevant to the user. An algorithm partial detailed extension and relevance is an algorithm that returns the fraction of detailed cells of Q which are covered and therefore considered relevant by the detailed areas of history queries over the total detailed cells of Q. The partial detailed extensional relevance for our previous example is 0.3, which means that 30% of the detailed cells of our query Q is relevant, are relevant to the detailed to the, of detailed areas of the history queries. Now we can assess relevance in the same level of aggregation in the case that the under question query Q and some queries of the history are in the same level. The algorithm performs a partial check between the cells of Q and the cells of history queries with the same level with Q and returns the ratio of the cells of their intersection to the total number of Q cells. Now, both these relevance algorithms have syntactic equivalents that compare query syntax instead of comparing the cells of their results. As for peculiarity, peculiarity is evaluated in discriminating a particular query from its peers in the history. We have syntactic peculiarity, which measures the peculiarity of a query by measuring its distance to the queries of the history by pairwise checking their syntactic distance. The syntactic distance of two queries is expressed by the weighted sum of structural distances between their selection conditions, their grouping levels, and their measures. Specifically, we use average as a metric in order to assess the distance, and we measure the average distance of each query structure to the respective structure of all the history queries. The total structural distance is the weighted sum of all structural distances between Q and the history queries. And specifically, we use 0.5 as selection condition weight, 0.35 as grouping levels weight, and 0.15 as measure weight. The syntactic peculiarity of Q is 0.74, which means that 74% of that, which means that the query is 74% peculiar with respect to its peers in the history. Now, value peculiarity is computed as the kth element as, of a sorted list which contains the Jaccard distances of the detailed area of the under question query Q to the detailed areas of the queries of the history. In our implementation, we return the first element of the list, which is the element with the maximum distance and therefore the maximum peculiarity. In the same example, the value peculiarity of Q is 0.83. Which means that the cells of Q are at most 83% peculiar with respect to the cells of the history queries. Finally, surprise. Surprise is a measure that depends on prior interestingness dimension that depends on prior beliefs, evaluating how far from the prior beliefs of the analyst do the actual values lie. For each cell, we have its actual value m and an expected value me. And the absolute distance between N, M, and M, E is the surprise of the cell. Well, we have an algorithm for surprise which returns the average cell surprise for the query, and the algorithm computes the absolute distance for each cell of the query between the actual and the expected value, if it exists, sums up all the cell surprises and divides it with the number of the cells that had an expected value. For the query of our example, the average cell surprise is 8%. Now we have some experimental results, and we test the performance of the algorithms that use history by increasing the fact table size and the history size. We also assess the performance of algorithms that use beliefs by increasing the result size of the executed query. All the experiments are performed on the long cube of PKDD99 star database. And we have the results that the detailed novelty algorithm execution time is linear with respect to the table size and the query history size. Belief-based novelty algorithm execution time is linear with respect to the table size. And belief-based novelty algorithm is much faster because it does not calculate the detailed areas of all the history queries. As for relevance algorithms, detailed relevance algorithm execution time is linear with expected to table size and query history size, and partial same level extensional relevance is linear with respect to the result size. Of course, same level extensional relevance is much faster because we have no calculation of detailed areas at all. Syntactic peculiarity execution time is linear with respect to the history size, and value peculiarity execution time is linear with respect to the table size and to the history size. Syntactic peculiarity is faster because it simply performs syntactic comparison and does not calculate detailed areas. And finally, for the surprise algorithm, we have a theoretical analysis that the execution time of the algorithm should have a linear increase with respect to the result size, which is not exactly achieved. We relate this variation due to the fact that the probability of hitting an expected value when the result size of query is larger. Finally, we believe that we have addressed the problem of assessing the interestingness cube query in the context of a hierarchical multidimensional database. We discussed four interestingness dimensions: novelty, relevance, surprise, and peculiarity, and we have proposed specific algorithms for their assessment. We discriminate signature-based algorithms before the query is executed, which is a priori interestingness, and result-based algorithms after the query execution, which is a posteriori interestingness. As future work, we can include more algorithms towards the solution of the problem, and moreover, beyond our four interestingness dimensions, another notable dimension concerns the expression aspect, in which data are assessed for their fitness to the medium that is used to express them. Finally, we have all our code available at our Dalian Cubes engine at GitHub, and we have a long version of this paper available at Archive. Thank you.